Hey YouTube, Siam here. It's been a couple of days since I've said anything, so I thought I'd do a little update. Hope it helps. So let's just... let's go back. It feels like a long time ago. It's really only just 2 days. So what I was seeing a couple of days ago was this rising compression on wrapped memo, and I was saying that this is something to be aware of because rising compressions are probably one of the best bearish continuation indicators out there. And as a result of that, I did another sidestep because of that sidestep, because of that rising compression. And as I said here, so some people are saying that, you know, it's me that's causing all of these crashes, but it really isn't. And I just wanted to double stress that, look, all of this crashing happened even though I was holding $3 million worth of time. So these technical playouts, patterns will play out regardless of whoever stays in or out. And so here was another rising compression. And I was just saying this is an inevitability whether I trade it or not. So I decided to trade it. I got out, got back in, and as I said here, when was this? Probably yesterday, last night actually. I said, no, I know there may be buybacks, as in with Wonderland, but I'm just going to go by the chart and eyeing up a re-entry around 48 to 50K. That's not what normally happens. That's what normally happens when I see this picture in any other asset. So sometimes you have to decouple what you think from what you see. And every single time I've lost money in the markets is when I've traded with what I think and ignored what my eyes were actually showing me. And so whenever you see a market absolutely spitting down, you'll always see a natural relief rally like so. And when you have sort of a drying up in movement and you have this sort of dribbling down phase, you nearly always see a move down. So I sidestepped. I forgot what time I sidestepped, but if you go to the wallet and go to history, I got out... Here we go. Was it 1:30 in the afternoon? So sold all of my wrapped memo there, and I'm still sat in MIM. So just waiting for a re-entry. Now, here's the other thing. As I was explaining, so this was again last night. I was looking at Bitcoin and looking at this trend line, and that. I saw this lovely high test. Again, this is another different type of strategy, but I was saying that this is, that Bitcoin move up got rejected nicely, should move down now. And this was, what was it, just 43, 42 and a bit K. So that was 9:15, and then literally what within that same hour, boom, the rejection played out. There we go, Bitcoin moving down, which will bring down most crypto, including wrapped memo. So then looking at Bitcoin again, so... that was that rejection, and I said that we'd see further falling down to 40 at the very minimum. So that was last night, and then today, guess what happened? We had that fall. So if we just open up Bitcoin, not only did we, if we go get out of the weekly, let's just jump down to that 4 hour chart. There we go. So that move down to 40 happened, and we had a little bit more. So why did that happen? The reason being, as I explained it in the trading pub today, the reason being is that I don't just look at wrapped memo. It seems like every crypto investor on the planet seems to just be staring at one chart. They seem to be just going, right, I'm trading wrapped memo, so I'm just going to look at this chart. And that's pretty myopic. If you are a myopic investor, you're going to lose money. I promise you. That's the only guarantee I can give you. Myopic traders lose money. Myopic dabblers lose money. So you have to always have a top-down approach. So always start with the Dixie, so the dollar index. And remember, whatever happens, so anything priced in the dollar will go down if this dollar index goes up. Like, you don't need to be an economist. You don't need to look at reports by the Federal Reserve or anything like that. Just keep things simple. Dollar goes up, everything priced in the dollar is going to go down. So I've been waiting for this fall down in the dollar for a while. it happened finally. I thought it would bounce off this level, but we had a bit of a fake out, but that bounce is now happening. And it's a strong bounce, not only, and this is gearing up to be very, very strong. So more movement upwards with the dollar means everything is going to go down against the dollar. So that means stocks. Well, guess what happened? Stocks moving down. NASDAQ breaching its base support. If you've watched my videos by now, you should know what a breaching of the base support level does. FTSE hasn't caught up yet, but it probably will. The US 30, again, starting to have its wobble. Is it breaching base support? Well, that's one at the moment, which is resting on. But we'll see. But the S&P 500, breached. So, yeah. So what this means is that if the dollar's going up, everything's going to fall. And also, Bitcoin is very correlated with stocks, simply because of the dollar index. So if we then move forward to Bitcoin, guess what? Bitcoin's going down, and everything crypto will go down because Bitcoin's going down. And Ether is somewhat correlated to Bitcoin, and so Ether will be doing its own thing. And guess what? Ether is absolutely shitting itself, as expected. I mean, I've been calling for Ether to fall all the way back since, was it 11th of December? I saw this topping pattern and said, yeah, we're gonna have a move down to 3,400. It got a bit delayed, but I stuck to my guns, and it did. We had another rising compression that fell. And so what I'm expecting right now, and yeah, my little white holes of my little white holes suck up the price, and the price always moves into these little holes. So we've breached this big level, this base level of support. So again, game over. We're going to probably have a pullback and then further falling, because further falling is most likely to happen with Bitcoin. I've been calling 36 to 38k Bitcoin for a while now. So I'm expecting activity around here. Yeah, so between 36 to 38k, we're in the 38k zone already. And yeah, and so if you look at anything, every single, ignore some of these doodles. This is something I'm chatting with my traders. All of these doodles are coming true. Anyway, so Bitcoin, what's going to happen? Well, this is a falling compression, so we're going to have a squeeze to the upside. We just got to wait. What's happening, in my opinion, is no different than January 2021. It's capital allocation month by the big boys, as I've been saying. And so I remember the fear that happened with Bitcoin back in January 2021, where it went from 42 down to 30. Everyone thought it was going to go, you know, fall off a cliff. But look what happened. We had this falling compression. It breached it slightly early. Normally we have a breach at the sort of the last sort of 20% of the apex around here, but it breached early. And then obviously Wall Street is fully allocated. And then February, roaring February, fabulous February, let's call it. and I think what's happening now is just a bigger fractal of that. So long sustained bearish falling compression in a rising market, and therefore let's watch Bitcoin attack this bottom support and then bounce the hell out of this in February. So we're very close. So February, watch the tune of everyone change as Wall Street fills their boots and then hodls, and so this will start rising. And then really, once it gets, yes, when it breaches this compression, I'm going to be excited, but really it needs to get above this 42k level, stick the landing, and then bugger off. And then when Bitcoin resumes its bull market, every freaking rebasing DAO is going to explode to the upside. It doesn't really matter how shit or how good a DAO will be, they're going to go up when Bitcoin starts going up, because when Bitcoin goes up, Ether will go up, and everything follows Bitcoin and Ether. They're like the mummy and daddy of the crypto family. Yeah, so now let's look at the rebasing DAO. So time, you still have to keep track of it because it is, you know, half of the value variable of Wrapped Memo. Ignore all my little doodles, they're really for me. But basically, this is a massive resistance level which we did loads of sidesteps from. And it seems to be dribbling down this actual level. I think it probably, if I was being a bit more accurate, it'd probably be something like that. And it's just resting upon this. But everything is going to fall. There is not a single rebasing DAO out there which I think is doing well at the moment, or will do well until Bitcoin gets out of its slump. And because I think the dollar is going to explode up north, we got further falling with Bitcoin, boys and girls. So don't call me a FUDder or a hate spreader. I'm not. I'm just showing you what the markets are showing us. This is what the charts are showing. So get over your emotions and look with your eyes. It's highly probable that Bitcoin is going to fall a little bit further. I think it probably got one more surge down, which means, you know, no matter how much I like Wonderland, wrapped memo is going to keep on falling with it. This is why I'm sat in MIM, and I could literally buy in right now and have probably a 3 or 4 uplift of my wrapped memo, which will be, you know, a 200k uplift, something like that. But there's not much point, not when there's an impending further fall with Bitcoin. So I'm sitting tight for now. This trend line seems to be supporting it, as in the support level is actually supporting it. It just seems to be dribbling through here. Although, you know, the protocol will back the backing price. Don't forget the backing price is also falling with the market. So if you were to just simply look at this, the other day I remember the backing price was around 56k. Last time I checked it was 51, 52. No. Let's have a burner wallet. This burner will do. Okay, 52.362. So yeah, we're slightly below backing, but you know, the Wonderland team are not gonna execute a buyback when it's just a few pittance below backing price. They're looking for a discount as well. So they're probably looking for a couple of percent discount at least. But and they're, you know, Sifu's a dynamic person. He's switched on. He knows his shit, and he's most likely thinking the same stuff. He's probably thinking, yeah, with his market experience, I'm expecting a retest of at least 40,000. So it'll be great to buy in around sort of this level. I would hazard to say something around here would be pretty damn sweet. And nearly always, when you have a big shitting down like this, the market will retest that for a second bite of the cherry. Nearly every, you can look at any market pretty much, and every time you see a massive shitting down like here, when it crashed below 100k and hit 97, guess what happened? The market retested it. You can look at any market. In fact, let's just go into Bitcoin. Look at this. Bitcoin absolutely cratered down to 42. It then recovered quickly. But guess what happens? You always have another bite at the cherry. In any big crash, look, another big shock to the system at 30k, natural relief rally. What happens? Another bite at the cherry. Always. I mean, I've been trading for 18 years. My subconscious has basically seen that pattern happen like a billion times. So for me, I look at this chart and go, yeah, I'm not touching it with a barge pole at the moment, but I do want to get back in. But in my humble opinion, and you know, honestly, I'm a nobody from Norwich. I'm not touching this yet. Not until Bitcoin is finished shaking out all of the weak hands. Not until the market is flushed out all of the people that are liquidating. And by the way, I'm in the Wonderland Discord, and honestly, seriously, folks, has no one learned their lesson? I scroll through the general tab, which is probably the most degen thread in here, and everyone is still trying to lever up. Like, have you not learned that this massive crash was due to people getting liquidated that are levered up? Do not use leverage with crypto. You're literally asking to get bent over. And I've said this for years. So many times I've seen people go, oh yeah, but my liquidation level's really low. Well, I even Sifu thought he wasn't going to get wrecked. And he got liquidated. Obviously, it's probably a very small percentage of his wealth. But still, don't use leverage. You're asking for pain. I never touch it. Right, they're just my two thoughts. I saw loads of people saying, hey, you've gone quiet. Well, it's been like a couple of days. I haven't really gone quiet. But just my two pennies worth. And I will see you soon. Toodles.